been going traveling to Seattle, Jeff? Mr.
Well, yeah, my new gig at PopCap. Last week was the first week I did that, and I'm off again tomorrow for to do it Monday through Thursday. So it's going to be interesting. I'm sure there's a lot of people out there who do this, who have this kind of life where their job is in another city, and they do a lot of plane travel. It's certainly new to me, and you know, the idea is that eventually it will settle down so that I can work at home more. But you know, especially at the beginning, I sort of I, and they're being very cool with me. They're being very much like, you know, like I was there last week, and they were saying I didn't necessarily have to come this week, but I sort of feel like I do. I don't think, you know, when you're new at a job, I don't want to just suddenly like not be there, you know. And I don't want people down there, or people in Seattle, going like, w you know, what do we hire that dipshit for? You know, where the hell is he? You know, I want to show that I'm there, and I'm part of the team. But that's certainly the biggest ch going to be the biggest challenge for me going forward, is trying to balance work and home life that way.
Yeah. I hear that it gets a lot more complicated when you do get the second family and you're like living that double life.
Right, I know. But on the other
Yeah.
hand, you know, if I find a second wife who cooks well, I'm set in both cities, right?
Fourth meal and a second wife. Jeff Green's fourth meal.
Yeah, I was it's funny, I was when I was debating with different people, or just like weighing my options of the jobs, because I was sort of mulling over two jobs at once, and the PopCap one was one of them. And I'm not going to name names, but a guy in the industry who we know, when I mentioned PopCap and the deal, his first response back was, "Dude, Seattle girlfriend, you got to do it."
Oh, shit,
Oh,
dude.
man. Wow.
Yeah,
So you
like.
followed through.
So I followed through, right? Yeah. So I'm taking applications for Seattle girlfriends. If you know, if any hot Seattle babes
This
want to
is you
hit me
just
up
venting because your
on
wife and
Twitter.
daughter wouldn't listen to this podcast. See, if you listen to the podcast, I've been up front. I've kept it all out there.
No, actually, this is passive aggressiveness on my part, because my wife actually went out of town with friends last night on my first day back. So,
Ouch.
I know. So I'm getting back at her. No, actually, it's all good. But yeah, I so far so good. I mean, I'm you know, I don't want to EA is past history and what happened, but you know, but I made sure that when I, you know, part of my hesitancy in going to a place like PopCap or going to any game company was I wanted to make sure I didn't sort of find myself in the same situation I was in before. And so I played very hard to get. I mean, I wasn't playing. I was hard to get with PopCap for a while, because I wanted to make sure that I wasn't going to be giving up certain things. And things like this podcast were on the table. I was like, I need to be able to have this kind of voice and public identity. I didn't want to give that up. And the feeling was, actually, they didn't really give a shit. They were fine with
People used to just like eat a bag of M&Ms to get that endorphin rush back then, and now it's like, we'll go make a podcast or we'll go make a tweet that lets people know we need some attention. And you were upfront about it. You're like, you know what? I quit the M&Ms now and then. I need to get my dick sucked.
Pretty much. I think it's less that then I just got, you know, because here's what happened. When I left EA and I had that you know, 6 weeks of freedom, I realized how much I missed just being able to talk about other games and stuff in public. You know, I missed just being able to like play StarCraft and then go up and just say whatever the fuck I thought. You know, I did that my whole career. That's what my career was about. It was about talking about games in public. And so I, you know, it was stifling that I couldn't do that, or I could do it, but I had to be careful and watch every single tweet and make sure I wasn't saying something good about the competition or bad about the competition or whatever, which I understood their point of view. I'm not bad mouthing them. I get it from their corporate point of view. And you know, the times that I blew it, that was on me. That was my fault, not EA's, because it was clear what I was supposed to do and not to do.
Right. So, I mean, you agreed. You took the position and you agreed to their terms.
I agreed. And so, right. So I was in the wrong. It was just that I missed it.
It was harder for you, too, I would imagine, because the position you took had things in common with what you did previously. Whereas
right.
for me, it's like the same rules are there, but it would just be like, you know, you need to decide. Are you going to, do you want to be someone who talks about games critically in public? Or do you want to be, you know, a game designer?
Right, that's correct.
I would much rather, you know, for me, it's easier. I mean, I'd much rather be a game designer than do that, although I'll always miss that.
Right. And, you know, if you go back and look at my year on The Sims, I was quieter during that period. And that's because I was into that, and I was able to sort of, I was sort of enjoying that transition in my life just the way you are now.
Mm-hmm.
But it was the fact, like you're saying, that I ended up back in a public job, that it became super hard for me to be in public and yet not be able to say how I felt.
Right.
You know, it was a really weird situation to be in. So this time I said, I'll come back in public. But then I want to sort of really be able to just be me. And they've been overly generous that way. Like, we want you to be you. We want Jeff Green to be representing PopCap and not, you know, robot Jeff Green. But that's only part of my job anyway. I mean, I'm in the marketing department, which is where I belong, really, for this kind of work. And so a lot of my work is also going to be internal, helping them with their projects in different ways. And that is the part I'm really excited about, too, just learning that aspect of the business.